Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how to make a parametric cylinder with rounded or filleted edges in Sketchup with Viz Pro. I've opened a new file in Sketchup, and you can see up here there's these two little icons here. One says Start Viz, and the other one says Set Geometry Source. Today we're only going to be using Start Viz. We're not going to be setting any geometry sources because we're going to be making the geometry in Viz itself. I'm going to just double click that. It's going to bring up this window. Viz is a paid software, but you can check the description below for a 15-day free trial. That's an affiliate link for me, so if you decide to purchase, I do get a commission from that, so you can help support this channel by doing that. We're going to be making a ton of parametric modeling videos now that we have Viz, so I highly recommend go checking it out and at least trying the trial. On this window, we have our node area here and our preview area here. And then we're going to start to just put in some nodes and connect them together to do the parametric things that we want. I'm going to try to take this as slow as I can because I know it can be confusing. And if you're trying to model a parametric cylinder, chances are that you're pretty new. So we're going to go to primitive here, and that gives us some basic shapes. So what I'm going to do is hit cylinder. See, I get this little guy over here. Just zoom in a little bit. And then you can see when I mouse over that I get some more information about what this node does. So I have preview here. If I double click that, you can see my preview over on this side disappears. A Boolean value is just an either or sort of thing. So it can be true or false, which is also the same as one or zero, or yes or no. It's sort of all the same thing. Boolean can be one of two things. Plane, I don't fully understand what that does yet. We'll probably get there later. Radius is obviously the radius of the cylinder, and height is the height of the cylinder. And the C here is basically if you want to start to do some parametric things to it outside, like it needs to do something through something else, that's where you would connect. And that's typical for all nodes, so the bottom thing is sort of your go-to for when you're connecting nodes. The first thing that we're going to do with the cylinder is make it so that we can dynamically change the height and width of our cylinder. So the height and radius. If I double click radius here, I can parametrically change the height and radius this way. But we're going to make it a little bit easier. So what I'm going to do is go to input slider. Put the slider here. I'm just going to copy and paste that. And then double click on this so that I can rename it. Radius and height. We're just going to drag from this over and here. Now I can a little more easily adjust the parameters of a model. See, nothing is coming over to SketchUp yet, and we'll get to that a little bit later. I've gotten hung up on this a few different times, so I'm going to show you how I get hung up and then how we'll resolve it. So the next thing that I would do is do fillet. Double click that. That'll give me this node here. And so what I would do is go to cylinder, hit B rep, and then probably make another one of these. You just double click on this line once to get rid of a node point. So let's say fillet radius. And then I would connect this with this R here. So I have my B rep, which is a boundary representation, and then I'd start to move the slider and nothing would happen. So, and this is actually part of what we're doing. This is, yeah, we need to do this. But what we're missing is telling Viz what we want to fill it. So it has this geometry and says, okay, well, this is the geometry that I'm going to do, but it doesn't know what edges that we want to fill it. So if I hit space, that'll bring up this create node search window. And what we want to look for here is BREP. You can see there's this thing called BREP components here. I'm just going to double click that. It's going to give me a new node here. Now, what B-Rep components is it basically breaks down your B-Rep that you're putting in here. So if I attach this, it's going to your B-Rep decompose. And then where it says T for type, currently it's set to vertex. So if I double click that, you can see I can change this to different things. I'm going to type edge here. And then attach this to this E on fillet, which is here. However, even when I go to this fillet radius now, nothing happens. What's happening is that Viz is generating two different previews. There's a preview for this cylinder, and there's a preview for this filleted cylinder. Obviously, the filleted cylinder is smaller than the larger cylinder that is unfilleted. So what we need to do to resolve that is to double click on this. And there's nothing here. It's probably because my fillet radius is too big. So when I have a smaller radius here, it starts to fill it. We want to make this so that it's maybe not so much. I'm going to type 2 here. That way we can use our slider a little bit more effectively. Type 1. There we go. I'm also getting this red line. That is what the B-Rep component is doing. So if I double click that, the line will go away. Even though I have this cool parametric model in Viz, when I go to SketchUp, there's nothing in there. So it's not entirely helpful to have a preview of something that's cool, but not be able to edit it in SketchUp. The final step that we need to do is to export to SketchUp. So to do that, we're going to be using this thing called sync, and what we're going to be exporting is a shell. So we click on that and we get a new node here. We're going to export the filleted geometry and put that in a shell. And then when we go back to SketchUp, you can see that that geometry is in there. And even when I change it here, it's going to dynamically change in SketchUp as well. I would make sure for any syncs that you're doing to make sure to do that at the very end when your parametric model is working correctly. I've had a few models crash because everything wasn't linked up correctly and SketchUp was really confused when it got the geometry. So hopefully this helped. I'm really excited to make more videos on Viz Pro. If you have any questions about it or want to see something, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and like this video. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.